Hey guys, Momo Guru back. I'm just giving you a little update on what I've got going so far. I know it's been a little while since I made my last video, but I have been busy with work, and I've just now gotten a chance to really start focusing on some new updates for the game. All right, so you can see now I got planets. So you could see them before, but they never really did anything. But now the way that they work is very similar to a ship. You'll notice that I don't have a mothership because I haven't built one yet. All right, so when you start out with your planet, you've got various different structures that you can build that are going to start, giving you various different modifiers to some of the stats and stuff. For example, the more colony structures you build, the higher level of your population you can get to increase the growth rate of your population. You need more farms. You can increase your money by or your resources by setting up mining operations. You can build ships faster if you increase your shipyard and things like that. All right, so one of the things that is a little bit different is the workers. I'm gonna go ahead and pump out a few recons of workers and research ship. But with the workers, so you can see these guys will pop out right here. These are my recons, so I'm going to put them in wall formation and just move them out of the way a little bit. And as soon as, where did that worker come out? You popped that right over here. All right, so we'll get that worker going on that. But you'll notice when, for planets, the workers will get within range of the planet and spit off the resources down to the planet, and you get your money. So it works the same way it would with a ship, except you can do it with planets. Having a ship or the mothership isn't any different, really. You can see I can go ahead and pump one out real quick here. It'll just pop it out in the center of the map, and then you can still build and do everything just the same. So you have your planet and your shipyard. Oops, your planet and your ships from there, and then you can open up your shipyard and build stuff from here too. And also, I have implemented hyperspacing. So you can see I don't have enough money for that right there. That's a little too big. So I'm gonna just give myself some free money and show you how the hyperspace works. All right, so we just spit it over there. Now, unlike some other games, including Homeworld, your ship disappears. That doesn't work the same way in this game. Your ship is actually stays visible the entire time. It actually just takes the moments to fire up the hyperspace. It's still able to be shot. It's still able to take damage, and then it zips through to wherever it's going, and then appears, and it's back to functionality again. So you can see that hyperspacing is very similar. If you put ships in formation, the whole formation will hyperspace together, so it works pretty easy. And strike craft and smaller ships do not have hyperspace abilities. But basically, what I wanted to show here is how this works. I'm going to go ahead from here. Did I build a research ship? I did. I need to research port utility drive. I think, yeah, utility support drive. And I'm gonna hyperspace this carrier shipyard over to this planet. You'll notice the green ones here are showing the ones that I own. The red one, these are the enemy-owned ones, and these are unclaimed, so no one's colonized these yet. But to be able to colonize, I'm going to have to let's get that worker. I'm gonna hyperspace that worker over there too. But to colonize, I'm gonna have to build a colony ship. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that worker going, and then from here, I've now got that research finished. I can produce a colony ship. And then once I produce a colony ship, I can send the colony ship down to this planet, and then the planet will become mine. Now, planet doesn't have a health bar like ships do. Planets have a population bar. So destroying the planet's health is essentially killing off the population of the planet. And it's important that you have a good population on your planet because that's what provides you your support. So you can see my planet right here has a max of 40. So I'm getting a plus 40 here, and then I've also got over here a select it might help. Over here I've got my oh, I'm having a brain fart. This is my shipyard or carrier, and so that gives me another 50. And then right here you'll notice I have a colony ship, and that's where I'm getting that extra 5 from. So the colony ship will give you a little bit of support all on its own. But you're going to get a lot more if you take the colony ship, and you can do it a few different ways. You can go down here to colonize, and then click the colonize, to colonize the planet. Or you can, press the Z key and click, or you can hit Z and draw a bandbox around it. So either one of those are going to work. But basically what's going to happen is the colony ship's just going to head down for the planet. Right now I don't have any kind of special animation for it yet. It just gets close and explodes, where in the future you're going to see a nice little particle effect that, you know, kind of resembles the ship being sucked down into the atmosphere or passing through the atmosphere or something like that. So, let's see. I think that's pretty much it. I don't know if I have too many more other little features. Other than just, okay, so you can see now the planet belongs to us. And right here, you can see I don't have any structures built on there. The population is at 5 right now. And then when you notice the population go up to 6, you'll notice my maximum supports go up. And there we go. So I went up to 6, and now I'm at 96. So taking over planets is how you can support growing a large fleet to defend yourself. Some of the things I'm going to do in the future here, I'm just now getting this all hammered out. I am going to build, from the planets you can build structures and shipyards. I'm highly considering go ahead and putting research on the planet as well, so you don't need to build a research ship or a research lab. You can do it from the planet. And then I'm going to separate things to where planets can research certain types of things and ships can research certain types of things. And then there are certain things that planets and ships can both research. Same with construction. So the shipyards and carriers will be able to produce some types of ships. The planets will be able to produce other types of ships. And then the planets and the shipyards and carriers will all be able to produce some of the ships as well. So things like, you know, recons and workers and ore processors, everything can build those. But a carrier won't be able to build, let's say, a heavy cruiser. A shipyard might be able to build a carrier, but only a planet can build a heavy cruiser. So the way I break it apart is to kind of control what you're able to produce based on the kind of ships you have. And then obviously the support units, you have to meet those requirements. Alrighty, well, I really don't have any new videos to show you about combat or anything like that. Everything seems pretty much the same right now. I just started getting back into updating this interface and getting the planets to be part of the game. But as you can see, I'm making progress, and little by little I'm getting there. I would expect a playable demo here in the next few months. I'm back in the groove again, so I should be able to really start putting this together. I started working on a decent title screen, starting to put together what are the requirements for the save mechanisms and things like that. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video, and stay tuned. I should have another one posted within, 3 or 4 weeks. All right, guys, Mobile Groove signing off. Till next time.